Hello everyone, welcome back to today's lecture on multiplexer. Multiplexer is one of the important combinational circuit in our digital system design. In the previous class, we have seen about combinational logic circuit, and combinational logic circuit definition is, it is a circuit in which the output at present time depends only on the input at present time. So output is function of present inputs only. Therefore, it doesn't require any memory or clock, and it is having of n number of inputs and m number of outputs, and those may be greater than or equal to 1. And we have seen till now so many combinational circuits in the previous lectures, of starting from design of any conventional circuit using gates, then arithmetic circuits of adder and subtractor, and then we have seen decoder combinational circuit and encoder. Now in this class we are going to see multiplexer. In this lecture we are going to see multiplexer, and different sizes of multiplexers are, we are going to see as 2x1 multiplexer, 4x1 multiplexer, 8x1 multiplexer, and so on. The objective of today's lecture is, we are going to learn and analyze the operation of multiplexing and demultiplexing, and we are going to design different multiplexers of different sizes like 2x1, 4x1 and 8x1 and etc. And we are going to implement any combinational function using multiplexers. So any combinational circuit can be implemented using multiplexer. Okay, then outcome of this lecture is, after learning of the multiplexer designs, yeah, you will be able to explain the operation of multiplexer and design the different multiplexers and implement Boolean functions using multiplexers. Okay, so the contents for today's lecture are, it starts with introduction and need of multiplexing, purpose of multiplexing, then you are going to see applications of multiplexing, then the basic function of the multiplexer, and design of different multiplexers of like 2x1, 4x1 and 8x1 multiplexers. Then multiplexer tree is going to be implemented, that is larger size of the multiplexer using smaller size multiplexers. And then finally the implementation of logic gates and Boolean functions using multiplexers we are going to see in this lecture. First, what is the need of the multiplexer? Before going to see multiplexing, we have to see no multiplexing. No multiplexing means without multiplexing. So in our communication system, always we are going to have transmitters and receivers. Okay, now let us see one case of example. In the transmitter side, four systems are there, and in the receiver side, four systems are there. To have a communication between one system to the other system, from the transmitter side to the receiver side, if dedicatedly one channel is used, that is called as no multiplexing. Okay, simultaneously while transmitting a message from multiple sources to multiple destinations, between one source to one destination, if dedicatedly one channel is specified, then it is called as no multiplexing. So because of this, what is the disadvantage? Disadvantage is cost factor. It is cost expensive because all are going to have dedicated paths. Then multiplexing. With multiplexing means, see here, same four transmitters and four receivers, and these are connected through a single channel. This is a single channel. These two are connected through a single channel with the help of two devices. One is called multiplexer and another one is called demultiplexer. So the combination of multiplexer channel and demultiplexer is called as multiplexing. This is called as multiplexing. Okay, so what it is doing, it is using a single channel means, so it is cost effective technique. Using two devices, many number of transmitters are going to be used single channel, and from the same channel many number of receivers receive the signal. With the help of two devices, this is possible. Those two are called as multiplexer and demultiplexer. If it is using, then that is called as multiplexing. Multiplexing means a single cable or radio link can handle multiple number of signals simultaneously with a technique called multiplexing. And this multiplexing permits hundreds or even thousands of signals, to be combined and transmitted over a single medium. And so because of this, cost saving is the advantage. Cost saving can be gained by using a single channel between multiple sources and destinations. So that is this technique. That is the multiplex. What is the purpose of multiplexing? Purpose of multiplexing is simply sharing a medium. Sharing the medium, that is because using a single channel by the multiple sources is nothing but sharing multiple sources the single channel. So sharing the medium is nothing but the purpose of the multiplexing. Let's see example here. Three sources and three destinations. Okay, three speech signals are transmitting and here three speech signals are hearing. In a sense, here sender 1 and receiver 1 are connected with a one path, and sender 2 and receiver 2 are connected with one more path. Then sender 3 and receiver 3 are dedicatedly connected with a channel. So three number of channels are used. Three channels are used to connect, to have a connection between sender 1 to receiver 1 and sender 2 to receiver 2 and sender 3 to receiver 3. The same example, same three senders and three receivers are having a communication, but these three are mixed and using only a single channel. Okay, using only a single channel. It is called multiplexing. For that, so this multiplexing are transmitting these three sender signals combinedly, possible with the help of a device at the transmitter side called multiplexer, and in the receiver part that will be received and distributed to the three receivers by the demultiplexer device. So multiplexer is a device which permits the combination of or combining of all the signals and sending into one signal, and demultiplexer is a device which permits taking the one signal and distributing into many signals. So this is multiplexing case, multiplexing system, and it is no multiplexing system. So advantage is nothing but cost saving is advantage for the multiplexing system since a single channel is using. Okay, so what is happening here? Here the single channel is shared by three users. We are telling three users are sharing a single channel, and three users may be send the same signal or different signals. In this example, we are showing only three audio signals, but here those signals may be anything. Okay, from this we can understand that the signals may be, one may be a video signal, or one may be audio signal, or one may be a data signal. That is, here representing one fax machine, one telephone, and one mobile phone, etc. So any type of the signal can be combined by the multiplexer, and that will be sent through a single channel. Generally, the channel here, it is representing as optical fiber if it is a wired connection, and if it is a wireless connection, obviously this medium is our free space. Okay, like this, multiplexing is used for sharing the channel, and it is a cost saving technique. And in this multiplexing, multiplexer and demultiplexer, two devices will be used, and multiplexer we are going to see in this lecture, demultiplexer we will see in the next lecture. Finally, what we have seen till now, a multiplexing system. Multiplexing system uses both multiplexer and demultiplexer. Multiplexer is a circuit that accepts many inputs. This is very important. Multiplexer is a circuit that accepts many inputs and gives only one output. That means in the previous example, three signals and one output signal like that. It takes many inputs and gives only one output. And opposite action is going to be performed by the demultiplexer. That is, a demultiplexer function exactly in the reverse of a multiplexer. That is opposite function or reverse function. That means demultiplexer accepts only one input signal and gives many output signals. So multiplexer takes many inputs and give one output, and demultiplexer takes one input and give many outputs. So from this figure we can understand that multiplexer is taking the four signals A, B, C, D, and it is sending this signal to a single channel, and demultiplexer is taking a single signal and it is distributing again back to its original form, that is A, B, C, D signals. So combinedly this total system is called as multiplexing. Then these two important devices are multiplexer and demultiplexer, and these two multiplexer and demultiplexers are combinational circuits. In our practical applications, in the telecommunication example, the telecommunication networks, these multiplexers and demultiplexers are used, and in the practical field, the multiplexer system is using the name of PC8300T1 bar E1 fiber optic multiplexers, and these are like these boxes. These boxes will perform both multiplexing and demultiplexing. So one will be used at the transmitter side and one will be used at the receiver side, and different signals will be connected to that. Here in this example we are showing as, so from telephone wire signal will be connected, and from router, and from smart jack, and from the public exchange also. All these signals are available as T1 by E1. That means all these are in the PCM format, pulse code modulation format. This you will learn in the next years. In the next year, you are going to know this in the digital communication subject. So all different signals are mixed by this multiplexer, and that will be sent to a optical fiber cable. Here these two are connected with optical fiber cable, and then again it is received by the demultiplexer and it distributes to the respective destinations this side. That is, telephone signal as it is to telephone, and fax signal to other side switches, and then exchange signal to exchange, like that. So like that, each and every transmitter signal will be received by that particular respective receiver in the receiver side. Okay, this is our practical telecommunication network using this multiplexers and demultiplexers. In our day-to-day life, in our homes or offices, we will see a typical application for the multiplexer like this. That is, we are going to have one sound system, and we are using that sound system for many number of input connections. That is, if we want to connect that sound system to MP3 player, or to a laptop, or to a DTH connection, or a cable TV connection. So now, for each and individual input, we are not going to use those many different sound systems. We are using only one sound system, but one will be connected at one time. Now, one selector switch is used. That selector switch is called here as multiplexer, to select which device has to be connected to that sound system. Okay, so that is actually a multiplexing in our homes or offices. So here this multiplexer is having of four inputs, because here four input devices are using, and one output signal, so only one output system is there. And out of these four, at a time one signal is going to be connected to our sound system. So for the selection of these input devices, selection signals will be used. These are called as selection signals. Depending upon these selection signal values, any one of the input will be connected to the output. So when the selection signals are 00, MP3 player signal is going to be connected to the sound system, and if the selection signals are 01, then laptop sound card signal is going to be connected to the sound system and then if it is 10 our DTH connection, or if 11 cable TV connection is going to be connected to our selector switch, so that sound system is going to be used by that particular input. Okay, so this is a typical example which we are seeing in our daily lives. I hope with this you understood the need of multiplexing and purpose of multiplexing and typical applications of multiplexing. Okay, so what are the applications of multiplexing? Applications of multiplexing are, number one is communication systems, number two is telephone network. In all the communication system is from one system to another system connection is nothing but a communication. So in all the communication systems and in all the telephone networks, this multiplexing and demultiplexes will be used. So with this, I hope you understood introduction to the multiplexer. Now, start actual technical content of multiplexer. What is a multiplexer? What is technically the multiplexer? The multiplexer is a digital switch. Multiplexer is a digital switch that has multiple inputs. That means the sources, inputs are called as sources, and single output, that is destination. It means it is a digital switch which has multiple sources of inputs. Multiple sources means many signals as input and have single output. Means single output signal. So taking the many input signals and giving the single output signal is circuit is multiplexer. And connecting inputs to output is done by selection signal. So the selection lines determine which input is connected to the output. The selection lines determine which input is connected to the output. So these two are, from these two statements we can define number of inputs and outputs and selection lines for a multiplexer. So this is represented as a symbol, like this. Multiplexer symbol is representing like this, and it is taking a many inputs, that is representing as 2 power n inputs, and single output, that is representing a single output here. And always any one of the input will be connected to the output, that will be decided by the selection lines. So for these 2 power n inputs, n selection lines will be used. So the size of the multiplexer here, it will be defined as, size of the multiplexer as 2 power n by 1 multiplexer for n selection lines. For n selection lines, if selection lines are n, then its size is 2 power n by 1 multiplexer. Okay, now based on these selection lines only, there are different multiplexers. That is, if number of selection lines is equal to 1, then if we substitute here 2 power 1 by 1, that is equal to 2 by 1 multiplexer. If number of selection lines are is equal to 2, then 2 power 2 by 1, that is 4 by 1 multiplexer. Like that, if number of selection lines are 3, it is 8 by 1 multiplexer. If number of selection lines are 4, it is 16 by 1 multiplexer. And so on. If number of selection lines are increased, then sizes of the multiplexers will be increased. So the size of the multiplexer based on basically the selection lines. If selection lines are n, then its size will be defined as 2 power n by 1 multiplexer. Now let us see the design of different multiplexers of these. So let's start with 2 by 1 multiplexer. And before starting of this 2 by 1 multiplexer, let's understand the function of the multiplexer. It's a function is representing as a functional diagram like this, and it is actually represented with a rotatory switch. Okay, a rotatory switch is used to represent the function of the multiplexer. That means here it is having multiple or many input positions and only one output position. This is one output position and all these are input positions. Input, this switch is having a many input positions and single output position, and the output is connected to input to one position at a time. So if the switch cable will be connected to this position first, and then this, and then next position, like that, it will be rotating. That's why it is called as rotatory switch. Using a rotatory switch, we can understand the function of the multiplexer. And the switch position, output switch position, is connecting any one of the input positions, and that a particular input position will be decided by the selection signals. Based on the selection values, the output will be connected to one of the input positions. Okay, so that will be understood by this image here. That is, here selection signals are 2, and so since selection signals are 2 means, if n is equal to 2 means our 2 power n size is 4, so it is simply representing 4 by 1 max, 4 inputs and 1 output. And these 4 positions are defined, are out of 4 positions, 1 position will be connected to output based on the selection values. Observe here, selection values are changing from 0, 0 to 1, 1, because since 2 lines are there, the combination of inputs will be 0, 0 to 1, 1. So it is changing from 0, 0 to 1, 1. Observe here, if it is 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1 and 1, 1, changing. And based on this, one time the switch is connected to first signal or second signal, third signal or fourth signal, like that. And 0, 0, it is connecting to 1, and 1, 0, second position, 0, 1, third position, and 1, 1, fourth position, it is connecting. So whenever it is connecting means the same signal is transmitting to output. Okay, output is connected to first signal or second signal, third signal, and etc. based on these selection values. So this is like a rotatory switch. So its function can be modeled with a rotatory switch. Now let's start design of 2 by 1 multiplexer. 2 by 1 multiplexer means what? It is a combinational circuit which has 2 inputs and 1 output. From the name itself, it is having 2 inputs and 1 output. And for this, how many selection signals are used? 1 selection signal will be used. So 2 inputs, 1 selection signal, and 1 output. And based on the selection value, output will be connected to either I0 or I1. Only 2 signals. So at a time, either I0 will be transmitted or I1 will be transmitted based on the S value. So therefore, it is called as data selector. Data select, it selects the data output, is going to select the input data based on the S value. Okay, so therefore it is called as data selector. Now design processor, a design processor of combinational circuit, we know the first step of oral description, and the second step of finding the number of inputs and outputs, and third step of giving letter names to inputs and outputs, and fourth step is having a truth table with relation between inputs and outputs, and then writing the logic expressions, and if possible simplification, and after simplification having the simplified expressions, and then finally drawing the logic diagram. These are the 6 steps we have seen in the combinational circuit design in our previous lectures. We need to follow the same procedure for design of this combinational circuit also. So by combining step 1, 2 and 3, I am writing here oral description along with inputs, outputs and its names. What is a 2 by 1 multiplexer? 2 by 1 multiplexer is a combinational circuit which has 2 inputs and 1 output, and based on the selection line of yes, it is going to select output from the inputs. Let us take inputs as yes, output as z, and inputs as I0 and I1. Selection signal as yes, I0, I1 are the inputs, and z is the output signal, and it is 2 by 1 max. Okay, then what is the next step? Next step is writing the truth table and describing the relation between inputs and outputs. So write its truth table. It is our step 4 actually. So input is yes and output is z. In the truth table, we are going to represent only input yes and output z, because based on the selection value only output will be defined. So if s is equal to 0, z is equal to I0. If s is equal to 1, z is equal to I1. It is the truth table representation of 2 by 1 multiplexer. Based on the s value, when s is equal to 0, then I0 is going to the z. When s is equal to 1, then I1 is going to z. So therefore, when s is equal to 0, I0 is output, and when s is equal to 1, I1 is the output. And from this, if you want to write a logic expression with minimization, so minimization is not possible. Directly we can write logic expression. That is the next step. So logic expression for this 2 by 1 multiplexer, since it is having a single output, we are going to have only single output expression. That is equal to z is equal to, how can we write that this first combination? When s is equal to 0, output is equal to I0. So s is equal to 0 is representing as s bar, and at the time output is connecting with I0 of input. So s bar into I0 plus, and when s is equal to 1, output is equal to I1. How can we represent this? When s is equal to 1 means s into I1. So this is the logic expression. Z is equal to s bar into I0 plus s into I1. And the next step in our design part is logic diagram representation. So from this expression, we can draw the logic diagram and see, observe here it is using of one AND gate, another AND gate and OR gate with one inverter. Okay, so AND gate with inputs of first I0 is one input and I1 is another input. Original inputs I0, I1, and S signal is connected with bar to first gate and without bar to second gate. So take one inverter and connect to the first gate, and without inverter signal connect to the second gate. So S, and here it is S bar, and then these two are connected with OR gate. So therefore connect one OR gate at the output of these two AND gates, therefore output is equal to Z. So this is the logic diagram representation of our 2 by 1 multiplexer. Okay, so see, 2 by 1 multiplexer design starts with its definition and identifying its inputs and outputs. 2 by 1 multiplexer is having of two inputs with one selection line and with one output. And its relation between all the inputs and outputs is defined in this truth table. That is, when s is equal to 0, output is equal to I0. When s is equal to 1, output is equal to I1. And from this, we can write the logic expression z is equal to s bar into I0 plus s into I1. And if we represent that logic expression as a logic diagram, this is our logic diagram part. Okay, let's see once again. It's a logic symbol is representing like this, and then it's a truth table, that is relation between inputs and outputs, SZ, I0 and I1 in the outputs. And from this, if you write the logic expression, that is Z is equal to S bar into I0 plus S into I1, and from that logic expression, if you represent logic diagram, it needs two AND gates, one OR gate and one inverter. Okay. So I hope you understood this 2 by 1 multiplexer. Let's design next multiplexer, that is 4 by 1 multiplexer. So 4 by 1 multiplexer, from the name itself we can understand that is, it is having a 4 inputs and 1 output. Since it is using the 4 inputs, means how many selection lines are 2. So 4 inputs, 2 selection lines and 1 output. Okay. And out of the 4 inputs, so 4 inputs are represented like this, and 2 selection signals are represented here and 1 output is represented here. out of these four inputs, output is connected to only one input, either D0, D1 and etc. based on the values of these two selection signals. So, let's design this in terms of logic gates. A design part, starting with the verbal description, it is a multiplexer with four inputs and one output and with two selection lines, and it is representing directly as a symbol with four inputs, two selection signals and one output. Output is representing as and with letter Y, and selection signals are representing as A and B, and inputs are representing as D0, D1, D2 and D3. It is 4/1 mux. Okay, what next? Next is its truth table representation. Truth table. Truth table is having a relation between all these. So, let us have a relation between inputs and outputs based on the selection signal values. Okay, D and A are the selection signals and Y is the output signal. Now, since it is using two selection lines, four combinations will exist in the truth table. Now, based on these four combinations, output will be connected to D0 to D3. So, when selection signals are 0, 0, D0 is connected to output, then D1 will be connected to the D2, and the D3 will be connected when selection signals are 1, 1. So, this is the truth table of our 4/1 multiplexer. So, from this, if we write logic expression, that is logic expression part, what is the logic expression? Y is equal to, output is equal to, how can we write this? B bar A bar into D0, B bar A bar into D0, plus what is the second term? B bar into A into D1, plus the third term is B into A bar, B into A bar into D2, plus the fourth term is B into A into D3. That is B into A into D3. So, that is the logic expression. Logic expression is B bar A bar into D0, plus that is based on these four selection signals, B bar A bar, B bar A, B A bar and B A, into the respective inputs are written here. Now, next step is drawing the logic diagram part. So, what is the logic diagram for this? From this logic expression, we can understand that four AND gates are used and all these are connected to OR gate. Okay, final output is 1. So, that is coming from OR gate because plus is there in the expression, and to that OR gate, inputs are coming from the AND gates. Okay, so how many AND gates? 4 AND gates. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, 4 AND gates are using. 4 AND gates are connected to 1 OR gate. 4 AND gates are connected to 1 OR gate. So, that is output Y. And what are the inputs for these 4 AND gates? First AND gate, input is D0. Okay, then for the second AND gate, input is D1, and for the third AND gate, D2, and for the fourth AND gate, it is D3. All the four inputs. Then selection lines. So B bar, A bar are connected. That means let us take two inputs of, one is B with inverter, and another one is A with inverter. Okay, logic diagram representation. For the logic diagram representation, it uses 4 AND gates and 1 OR gate. Okay, for the 4 AND gates, external inputs are connected as D0 to D3 and selection lines connected as B and A to here, A, B and D3. And for the next gate, or the first gate, it is B bar and A bar, sorry, B bar and A bar, like this you need to collect. Okay, then here for the second term B bar, so this is A and B. B bar line is this, so B bar and A is going to be connected. A is this line, this is one, and the next one A bar and B will be connected, so that B is equal to this line and connect here. So like this, all the terms are connected with B bar A bar D naught and B bar A D1 and B A bar D2 and B A D3. All these inputs are connected to the 4 AND gates and that will be connected to a OR gate. This is the logic diagram of 4 by 1 multiplexing. Okay, let's see once again. It's 4 by 1 multiplexer logic symbol, that is using the 4 inputs with 2 selection lines and 1 output, and then writing the relation for all these using the truth table, that is this inputs BA and output Y. Based on these values, output Y will be defined, and then from this truth table, if we write the logic expression is, that is B bar A bar into D naught and B bar A into D1 and etc. So the last term is BA into D3. Then by using that logic expression, if we draw the logic diagram, then this will be the logic diagram. It is using the 4 AND gates with output 1 OR gate and inputs of D0 to D3 and 2 selection signals AB and 2 inverters to get B bar and A bar. Okay, this is our 4 by 1 multiplexer. I hope you understood the design of this multiplexer. 2 by 1 multiplexer design and 4 by 1 multiplexer design. Let's see the next multiplexer, 8 by 1 multiplexer. Follow the same procedure, and starting from its definition, it is 8 by 1 multiplexer means it is using 8 inputs and single output with 3 selection lines. Okay, and its logic symbol is representing with 8 inputs, 3 selection lines and 1 output, and its relation between all these inputs and output will be represented as a truth table like this. That is, based on the values of these selection lines S2, S1 and S0, output Z will be defined. Output is taking as Z and inputs are taking as I0, I1 and so on, I7 representation. So when these values are 0, 0, 0, then output is I0, and 0, 0, 1 output is I1. Like that, when these three values are 111, then output is equal to I7. So total 8 combinations, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Total of 8 combinations will exist because 3 selection lines are there. Yeah. And from this truth table, we can write logic expression, that is Z is equal to S2 bar, S1 bar, S0 bar into I0. Okay, like that and so on. S0, S1, S2 into I7. Total it is going to have 8 min terms in that expression. So that is Z is equal to 8 min terms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 min terms. That is from I0 to I7. All these are connected to Z depending upon the selection signal values. Now, after having this logic expression, next step is logic diagram representation. So logic diagram will be drawn based on that logic expression, that is it is using of 8 AND gates with 4 inputs. So 8 AND gates, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 8 with 4 inputs, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, inputs, and finally all these 8 will be connected to output. So this is the logic diagram for the 8 by 1 multiplexer. Here, observe one more signal, that is enable signal is represented. Without this enable signal also we can see, without this enable signal 4 inputs are enough. Okay, 4. If enable signal is added, that enable signal pin is added. So in the last few classes, in the encoder and decoder, we have seen enable signal. That enable signal is used for defining whether output is active output or invalid output. Okay, so for that reason, here with enable pin, it is represented. If enable is used, 5 inputs are required for each AND gate. Or if enable is not used, then 4 inputs are allowed. Without this E signal, without this enable signal, only 4 inputs will be used for AND gates. So like this, this is the logic diagram of the 8x1 multiplexer. I hope you understood 2x1, 4x1 and 8x1 multiplexer designs. Like this, you can design the next multiplexer also. Take that as assignment question. Okay. So now let's check our understanding with a small quiz. The first question: what is the size of the multiplexer? What is the size of the multiplexer? We have seen the size of the multiplexer as 2x1 max width n selection lines. For n selection lines, its size is 2n/1. This is the size of the multiplexer. Next, which circuit can be used as parallel to serial converter? Parallel means what? Parallel means many lines like this. Serial means single line. So this parallel to serial converter is what? Simply, this is, of course, it is our multiplexer. Okay, next. 4x1 max would have dash number of selection signals. So its size is 4x1. Just now we have seen here 2n/1 with n selection lines. 2n is given as 4. So that is simply 2/2. Therefore, how many selection signals it is having? 2. And next question. How many select lines are required for 128x1 multiplexer? Here it is simply 128 means it is 2/7 is 1. So therefore, number of selection lines are 7. Answer is 7 for this question. Next, MUX is also used as data selector. Is it yes or no? Data selector. Yes. Of course it is yes. Why it is yes? We have seen that multiplexer is having many inputs and selection lines and one output. Based on the values of selection lines, one particular signal will be connected to the output. Okay, in the sense it is nothing but based on the selection lines, data will be selected for the output. Therefore, it is called as data selector. So answer is yes. So with this, I hope you understood the design of multiplexer, definition and its symbol, and design of 2x1, 4x1 and 8x1 and so on, different sizes of the multiplexers. Okay, next. Our next point of today's lecture is multiplexer tree implementation. Multiplexer tree is nothing but implementing bigger size multiplexers with smaller size multiplexers. And in that only multiplexers are used. Therefore, it is called as tree. Okay. Multiplexer tree is nothing but implementing bigger with smaller size multiplexers. So the multiplexers with more number of inputs can be obtained by cascading two or more multiplexers with less number of inputs. Large number of input multiplexers will be obtained by cascading two or more multiplexers with less number of multiplexers. For example, that is 4x1 multiplexer using 2x1 and 8x1 multiplexers using 4x1 and 2x1 and 16x1 multiplexers using 4x1 and so on. So output is bigger size, 4x1, 8x1, 16x1 and etc. And using 2x1. So 2x1 is smaller when compared to 4x1. And here 4x1 and 2x1 for the 8x1. Therefore, these are smaller size. Okay. Smaller size multiplexers will be used for realizing of bigger size multiplexers. Let's see an example, 4x1 with 2x1 implementation. And before that, for that 4x1 multiplexer implementation with 2x1 multiplexers, cause how many number of multiplexers are required? Means to implement a bigger size multiplexer, how many number of smaller size multiplexers are required needs to be known first. For that, let's use this a simple formula. That is, to implement a B is to 1 multiplexer with A is to 1 multiplexer, where B is larger and A is smaller, that is B greater than A. Okay, then first use and take a formula of B by A. B is number of inputs of the bigger multiplexer and A is number of inputs for the smaller multiplexer. So number of inputs by number of inputs, that will give some number. This is this K1, this is nothing but number of multiplexers or number of outputs. Number of outputs in that particular stage. So the first stage will consist of K1 number of multiplexers. Then take the same K1 and divide with the number A, that is the multiplexer which we are using for the implementation. Then it will give K2. K2 is also number of multiplexers or number of outputs in the second stage. So this is the first stage and second stage, third stage, like that. Continue till last, getting till the one output, because the final output should be one. So divide like this till getting of one output of the multiplexer. Okay, so K1 first stage multiplexes, K2 second stage multiplexes, K3 next stage, like that. Last stage is a single multiplexer with one output. Okay, so what is our example? Our example is 4 by 1 multiplexer using 2 by 1 multiplexes. 2 by 1 multiplexes. What is B here? B is equal to 4. And what is A here? 2. So 4 by 2 is equal to 2. 2 multiplexes will be used in the first stage. This is equal to K1. Now take that K1 and divide with again A, that is 2 by 2. Okay? That is equal to 1. So, 1 output or 1 mux is enough. So, final output we got 1. Therefore, total number of multiplexes required to implement 4 by 1 using 2 by 1 are 3 multiplexes. 3 multiplexes are used for implementation of 4 by 1 with 2 by 1 multiplex. Let's see another example with a bigger size. That is, to implement a 64 is to 1 multiplexer using a 4 by 1 multiplexer, how many number of total multiplexers are required? So, 64 is our B value and A is our A value. First, have B by A, 64 by 4, that is equal to 16. What it is? It is equal to K1. First stage, number of multiplexers 16. Then take K1 by again A. Then it is equal to 4, it is equal to K2. Then take K2 as 4, 4 by A, that is equal to 4, it is equal to 1. This is equal to last K3. So K1, K2, K3 means 3 stages of multiplexes will be used. In the first stage 16, in the second stage 4, in the third stage single multiplexer. Now total how many number of multiplexes are used? That is 16 plus 4 plus 1. Those are 21 multiplexers. So, to implement 64 by 1 multiplexer using a 4 by 1 multiplexer, total number of multiplexers required are 21. And all these will be connected as a stages. Stages, the first stage, like this in the stages. First stage, 16 number of multiplexers. And all will be connected to second stage, 4 number of multiplexers. 4. And in the third stage, all these will be connected to a single multiplexer, like this. The first stage, second stage and third stage. In the first stage 16, in the second stage 4, and in the last stage 1 multiplexer. Finally, output is only 1. So total of 21 multiplexers will be used for 64 by 1 multiplexer using 4 by 1 multiplexer. Okay, now design our design. See a smaller one, that is 4 by 1 with 2 by 1 multiplexes. Just now we have seen how many number of multiplexes required there? 3. Okay? So, 3 multiplexes. How this will be connected? That is an important point. So, 4 by 1 multiplex means it is having the 4 inputs with 2 selection lines with single output. Output is Y and S1, S0 and let us take B0, B1, D2 and D3 as the inputs. Here, we are going to use how many? 3. Just we have calculated 3 2 by 1 multiplexes are required. So, in the first stage, 2 2 by 1 multiplexes. In the next stage, 1 2 by 1 multiplexer. So, these outputs will be connected here like this. So, this is the final output. So, inputs are B0, B1, B2, B3 and output is Y. Till this it is okay. Number of multiplexes connection we have seen. Okay. The important point is the selection line connection. Selection lines. It is 2 by 1, it is 2 by 1, and it is 2 by 1. So, one selection signal, one selection signal, one selection signal. For this also we need to remember one point, that is it is very very important. In the last stages, for the last stages, whatever the last stage is there, for the last stage, connect MSB selection signal. Connect MSB selection signal. MSB selection signal. And the first stage, whatever the first stage is there, for the first stage, connect the LSB selection signal. MSB selection signal. Okay, it is very important to remember. Remember that always. For the last stage MSB selection signal and for the first stage LSB signal, and in middle if we have any stages, connect middle selection signals. So here S1 and S0 are only 2 selection signals are there, and in this let us assume MSB is S1 and LSB is S0. Okay, it is of 4 by 1 mux. So LSB is S0, connect S0 to first stage multiplexes as selection line and connect S1 to the last stage multiplexer, that is S1 as the last stage. Okay. Now we can observe this operation. When S1 is equal to 0, the signal from the first multiplexer will be applied as output depending upon the S0 value. Then when S1 is equal to 1, then signal from the second multiplexer will be giving as output based on the value of S0. So, when S1 is equal to 0, D1 or D0 may be the output, and when S1 is equal to 1, D2 or D3 may be the output. Like this, we can implement 4 by 1 multiplexer using 2 by 1 multiplexer. And it is look like of 3 only with multiplexes, and it is starting one node and increasing branches. So, therefore, it is called as okay. Let's understand its operation part. What is a 4 by 1 multiplexer operation? When selection signals are 0, 0, first signal is the output, and 0, 1, I1 and 1, 0 selection signals I2 is the output, like that 1, 1, I3 is the output. This is the truth table. So now S0 is MSB and this is going to be connected for the second stage multiplexer. Well, S0 is equal to 0, outputs are either I0 or I1 from the truth table. So, when S0 is equal to 0, the output Y1 is going to be activated, whereas Y1 is either I0 or I1 based on the value of selection signal S1. Okay. So, when S1 is equal to 0, I0, so then I0 is Y1 and it is anyway 0. So, 0, 0 connection, I0 will be passed as Y. Right. If S1 is equal to 0, okay, the same I0 is passed. If S1 is equal to 1, that is the second case. S1 1, S0 0, then output should be I1. If S1 is equal to 1, I1 is the Y1 signal and S0 is anyway 0, therefore output is connected as I1. Therefore, when S naught is equal to 0, output is either I naught or I1. Okay. So, I naught or I1 is connecting from the upper multiplexer, that is I naught or I1 to the Y. Then similarly, if S naught is equal to 1, then Y2 is going to be activated. Y2 is the output Y. And that Y2 depends upon again S1 value. That S1 may be again either 0 or 1. If S1 is equal to 0, then output is I2. So here it is I2. The same I2 will be passed to Y2. That means S0 1 and S1 0. The next, if both are 1 1, then I3 is here Y2 first, and the same I3 will be passed to the Y2, and that Y2 is passed to Y. Therefore, output is I3. Okay. So, out of these four inputs of I0, I1, I2, I3, based on the selection values, finally, we are going to be achieved. So, this truth table can be achieved with the help of the connection of 2-by-1 multiplexers in this fashion. Therefore, 4-by-1 multiplexer can be implemented using 2-by-1 multiplexers. Like this, any size of the multiplexers can be implemented with smaller size of the multiplexers. Now, let's see another example, that is 8-by-1 multiplexer using 4-by-1 multiplexers. First, find number of 4-by-1 multiplexers required. How many number of 4-by-1 multiplexers required? So, here B is equal to 8 and A is equal to 4. Okay, what is the first step? B by A, that is 8 by 4, that is equal to 2. So, 2 is equal to the first stage multiplexes. 2 number of 4-by-1 multiplexes are the first stage. Then take that again 2 with the division with the A. A is nothing but what? 4. 2 by 4 we can't do. Okay, 2 by 4 we can't do. So, in the first stage, it is using 2 4-by-1 multiplexes. Means 2 outputs are there. So, for those 2 signals, we can't use 4-by-1 multiplexer. Therefore, we can use here 2-by-1 multiplexer. Okay, because if we take 2 inputs, then these 2 outputs will be converted into 1 output. So, for implementation of this 8-by-1 multiplexer using 4-by-1 multiplexers, 2 number of 4-by-1 multiplexers and 1 number of 2-by-1 multiplexer is required. This is the requirement of multiplexers. In the first stage, 4-by-1 multiplexers. In the second stage, 2-by-1 multiplexer. Okay? And these selection signals connection is also important. So, because 1 in the last stage, 2 in the first stage. So, for this last stage, connect the MSB bit of the selection signal. And connect here NSB signals, because only 2 stages are there. But this 8-by-1 multiplexer is using 3 selection lines. Okay. If those 3 selection lines are S2, S1, S0, SU, with S2 as MSB and S0 as LSB. Then connect S0 to 2, connect S2 to the last stage and S0, S1 to the first stage. Okay, so 2 4-by-1 multiplexers and 1 2-by-1 multiplexer with selection lines as S2 to the last stage and S1, S0 to the first stages. 4 inputs of 18 inputs and 2 outputs are connected like this. Finally, output is single output. Okay, so this is the number of multiplexers requirement and this is the connection of selection signals. This MSB to the last stage, that is for the 2-by-1 multiplexer, and these 2 for the first stage. Okay, let's see its diagram. That is the first stage 2 multiplexers in the last stage 1 multiplexer, and it is connected with MSB signal and connected with 2 LSB signals, S2, S1 and S0. Okay, and inputs are connected here, 4 inputs Then these two outputs are connected to 2x1 multiplexer. It is the final output. Now based on the S2, S1, S0 values, one of the input, that is from I0 to I7, will be passed to output Y. Okay. So this is implementation of 8x1 multiplexer using 4x1 and 2x1 multiplexers. Like this, we can design. See the next one as 16x1 multiplexer using 4x1 multiplexer. See, 16x1, it is bigger, somewhat bigger than 8x1. So 16x1, 16x4, it requires first stage as 4. And that 4x4 again, it is equal to 1. So how many total number of 4x1 multiplexers required? 4 plus 1, that is equal to 5 multiplexers. Okay. So see in this connection, 5 multiplexers. In the first stage 4, in the last stage 1. So in the last stage 1 and the first stage 4. Then what is the next important point? Next important point is selection signal connection. Selection signal, since it is 16x1, it is going to have 4 selection signals. If selection signals are A, B, C, D is used, A is the LSB and B is the LSB. So 4x1 multiplexer requires only 2 selection signals. So first LSB signals will be connected to the first stage. So C and D will be connected to the first stage multiplexers. See here, C and D are connected to the first stage multiplexers, and MSB bits, AB. AB are connected to the last stage multiplexers. Like this, we can design multiplexer 2. That means bigger size multiplexer implementation using smaller size multiplexers. Okay. I hope you understood multiplexer 3 implementation. So let's do some more questions as assignment, so that you can get better understanding. Design 16x1 using logic gates, because we have seen till 8x1 multiplexer with the logic gates. So design 16x1 multiplexer using logic gates. Then implement 8x1 using 2x1 multiplexers. Then implement 16x1 using 8x1 and 2x1. And implement 32x1 using 8x1 multiplexers. So these three questions are multiplexer tree implementations, and the first one is logic gate implementation. Okay, so solve these questions so that you can get better understanding of the multiplexer tree. Okay, so the third point of today's lecture is implementation of logic functions and logic gates using multiplexers. Okay. Coming to the next point, that is implementation of logic functions and logic gates using multiplexer. Here actually multiplexer is called as universal combinational circuit. Multiplexer is called as universal combinational circuit. Universal combinational circuit means it can implement any function with that multiplexer. Means starting from our logic gate to any complex function, multiplexer can be used. Okay, to implement logic gate to any function, multiplexer can be used. So therefore, multiplexer is called as universal combinational circuit. First, we will see logic gate implementation, and after that we will see a logic function implementation. So first, as an example, see the NOT gate, AND gate, OR gate, and then NAND or NOR, any one gate, and then XOR or XNOR. See, one gate from all these three combinations, that is basic gates, universal gates and arithmetic gates. Okay. So the first gate, let's see the NOT gate implementation using multiplexer. NOT gate implementation. So NOT gate, it is using single input and single output. Okay. One input and one output. Therefore, minimum size multiplexer is enough. Minimum size of the multiplexer is 2x1 multiplexer. So use 2x1 multiplexer to implement this NOT gate. Once if we have taken 2x1 multiplexer, means this 2x1 multiplexer, 2x1 multiplexer is using the two inputs, one selection signal and one output. But this NOT gate is using only single input. always it is better to use this input as selection signal here. Okay, so input of the gate is connected as selection signal here. Therefore, then depending upon the input, output will be defined for this gate, and whatever the output is required, connect here those output at the inputs of the multiplexer. So therefore, depending upon the issue, X is the input, but X is connected as selection signal, and depending upon the value of X, output Y will be defined, that is equal to Y. And if X is equal to 0, Y need to be some 0 or 1, then connect those two values here as the inputs of the multiplexer. Okay, let's see that. So for that, first we need to understand the truth table of this NOT gate. The truth table of the NOT gate is what? Input is X and output is taken as some Y. And when input is equal to 0, output is 1, and input is 1, output is 0. It is simply complementary of input. Okay, so X is a selection signal, then output will be what? Output will be either 1 or 0. Okay, taking X as a selection signal, this as a selection signal, and Y is having a 1 and 0 means, connect these two signals as input of the multiplexer. Input of the multiplexer. So X as a selection signal and 1 and 0 are the input of the multiplexer. Let's draw this. See, 2 by 1 multiplexer with X as the selection signal and inputs as logic 1 and logic 0. Logic 0 is applied here and logic 1 is applied here. That is, when X is equal to 0, then multiplexer gives I0 signal as the output, where I0 is connected with 1, so output is equal to 1. That is, X is 0, output is equal to 1. And when X is equal to 1, I1 will be the output, where I1 is connected with logic 0. So therefore, output is equal to logic 0. So X is 0, output 1, and X1 output is equal to 0. That is simply inverter operation. So connecting X as a selection signal and the values in the truth table are connected as inputs here for the 2 by 1 multiplexer. The same we can understood by seeing the logic expression also of the our multiplexer. What is the logic expression? How can we write X bar into 1? That is, output F is equal to output Y is equal to. So output Y is equal to, how we can write? Selection signal equal to 0 means X bar into, then it is passing as I naught, that is X bar into I naught plus X into, when it is equal to 1, it will be written as X and I1, where X bar into I naught is permanently connected to logic 1 plus I1 is permanently connected to logic 0. So X bar into 1 plus X into 0. Since X into 0 is 0, only X bar into 1 is the remaining one, that is equal to X bar only. Therefore, output is X bar for this 2 by 1 multiplexer, when inputs are connected with logic 1 and logic 0 here, with selection signal as X. So, output is X bar for input of X is nothing but simply NOT gate. So, like this NOT gate can be implemented using 2 by 1 multiplexer. Okay, I hope you understood. Like this we can do for other gates also. Let's see other gate. Implementation of AND gate using multiplexer. So take basic AND gate, the minimum size is with 2 input and single output. Okay, AND gate, and since it is 2 inputs and 1 output, here also take basic size of the multiplexer as 2 by 1 size. Multiplexer size is 2 by 1 and AND gate is 2 inputs and 1 output. So for this, first we need to understand the truth table of this AND gate. So from that, we need to get the relation for the expression in terms of multiplexer. The truth table of AND gate is, it is representing as, it is having of X and Y inputs and output is F. Okay, then What is AND gate function? When both the inputs are 1, then only output 1. For all other combinations, it is 0. From this, we can write a function between inputs and outputs by taking any one of these inputs as selection line. So, either of these two will be a selection line definitely. One selection line is required for our 2 by 1 multiplexer. And one input will be used as input. Okay. Input of the multiplexer is one signal and selection signal as one signal we are going to use. So, for that, by analyzing our truth table, if we are taking the X as a selection signal, if X is equal to 0 first, these two cases, if X is equal to 0, what is output value? Output is simply 0. So, when X is equal to 0, output is equal to 0. When X is equal to 1, then output is equal to what? 0, 0, 1, 1. That means, then output F is equal to the second input 0, 1. So, then output is represented as F is equal to the other input. Okay. Now, from this we are going to take a relation of, for the selection signal 0, output is always 0. So, connect the input of the multiplexer where it selects S is equal to 0 value with logic 0. And when selection signal is equal to 1, output is equal to Y. Then connect this Y signal at the input of the multiplexer when it selects as selection signal is equal to 1. Okay. Now by drawing this logic diagram, that will be look like this. It is using a 2 by 1 multiplexer where I0 and I1 are the two inputs. And from these two inputs X and Y, X is taken as the selection signal. So X is our selection signal. And when X is equal to 0, output is logic 0. Therefore, when X is equal to 0 here, I0 will be selected. So, I0 will be connected with logic 0. And when X is equal to 1, output is connected with other input that is equal to Y. Therefore, when X is equal to 1, I1 will be connected here. So, I1 is permanently connected to logic Y, other input of the AND gate. So, when X is equal to 0, logic 0 is output. When X is equal to 1, Y is the output. Okay. So, from this, if we have written logic expression, that is, F is equal to, how can we write? X is equal to 0 means X bar into I0 plus X into I1. That is our expression. That is, X bar into I0 is permanently connected to 0 plus X into I1 is connected to Y. Since this X bar into 0 is equal to 0, so final output is 0 plus XY is XY, where XY is our AND function. So, like this, we can implement AND gate using multiplexer. That is, connecting logic 0 at one input and one of the input of the AND gates as second input and other input as selection line. Okay. So, like this, we can implement AND function using multiplexer. Like this, you can implement an AND gate, OR gate, NOR gate and all the gates. Okay. And let's see one more somewhat complex example in this as XOR gate implementation. XOR gate implementation using multiplexer. XOR gate, here once again we are taking off two input XOR gate only, basic one, X and Y as inputs and F as output. And here for the XOR gate logic expression we can write as X bar Y plus X into Y bar. Okay. So, we are taking 2 by 1 multiplexer, 2 by 1 multiplexer like this. And always out of these two inputs, one will be the selection signal. Let us apply X here as a selection signal. It is a 2 by 1 max. Okay. Then output is F. Let us assume. So, we know the logic expression of the multiplexer, that is F is equal to X bar into I0 and X into I1. Now, think about I0 and I1 such that F is going to be equal to this. Okay. So, F is equal to, how can we write here? X bar into I0 plus X into I1. This is our expression. So, anyway, in this X bar we have, X we have. Here on X bar, X is there. Just simply selecting I0 and I1 values. I naught is what here? I naught is equal to y. Okay. If I naught is equal to y, here I get a term as x bar into y. So connect that y as I naught simply over. Then plus x into I1. I1 should be what here? Y bar. Y bar is required. So therefore, connect y bar. If y bar is connected, then simply y as one input, y bar as another input. Then when x is equal to 0, x bar into y plus x is equal to 1, x into y bar, that is equal to our two expressions equal. Okay. So by connecting y and y bar as inputs of the multiplexer and x as a selection signal with inputs of xy for the XOR gate, we can implement XOR gate using 2 by 1 multiplexer. Here, for getting y bar is what? XML inputs available are x and y, but y bar is inversion of y. For this y bar also, we need to use mux, because not yet need not to be used, because multiplexer is a universal combinational circuit. Just now we have seen not gate implementation of multiplexer. So therefore use that particular implementation of multiplexer to get the total implementation with multiplexers only. So let's see that implementation part. What is the first one? The first one is that x has a selection signal with y and y bar as connections. It is y and it is y bar connection. And for getting the y bar also has to be implemented with the multiplexer. So not gate implementation of multiplexer is used here to get y bar with y as the selection signal. So y is selection signal, then when y is equal to 0, logic 1 is output. When y is equal to 1, logic 0 is output. So here output is y bar, and the y bar is connected as the second input. Then it takes a selection line, y and y bar inputs. This output is simply x XOR with y. That is exclusive OR logic gate implementation of XOR logic gate implementation with multiplexer. Okay, like this you can implement any logic gate starting from basic to all the gates we can implement with multiplexer. Okay, I hope you understood the implementation of logic gates using multiplexes. Next, let's see implementation of any boolean function using multiplexes. Implementation of boolean functions. Okay, so before taking the implementation of boolean functions, take these questions as assignment questions. Implement OR gate using mux, implement NAND and NOR gates using mux, and XNOR gate. We have seen 3 gates, take the remaining 4 gates as assignment. Now let's see implementation of boolean function using multiplexer, boolean functions. Okay, this is the last topic of our today's lecture. Here, boolean function can be implemented with 2 sizes of the multiplexers. If a boolean function is using n variables, then it can be implemented with 2 power n by 1 multiplexer or 2 power n minus 1 by 1 multiplexer. For example, if number of variables are 3 for a boolean function, then it can be implemented with 2 power 3 by 1, that is 8 by 1 multiplexer, or 2 power 3 minus 1 by 1, that is 2 power 2 by 1, that is equal to 4 by 1 multiplexer. So if a boolean function is there with 3 variables, that can be implemented with 8 by 1 multiplexer or 4 by 1 multiplexer. So like this we can implement with 2 different sizes of multiplexers. Okay, let's see first with the 2 power n by 1 multiplexer implementation, and after that 2 power n minus 1 by 1 multiplexer implementation. As an example, the first one, that is implementation function using 2 power n by 1 multiplexer. The first example taking as a function f of a comma b comma c, that is n is equal to 3 with 3 variables, a sigma m of 1, 2, 5 and 7, it is having of 4 midterms. So using 8 to 1 multiplexer, in the sense if it is n is equal to 3, 2 power 3 is 8, it's a 2 power 3 to 1 multiplexer, that is 8 to 1 multiplexer implementation we have seen. Okay, so using ABC as selection lines, and whatever the minterms are given, these minterms, whatever the minterms are given, those minterms are connected with logic 1 and other minterms connected with logic 0, is a simple implementation of Boolean function of this with 8 to 1 multiplexer. Okay, so for that, first what we need to do, we need to have a truth table of this function. Truth table of the function, that is ABC, output F. In this function, minterm 1, 2, 5 and 7 are 1. 1, 2, 5 and 7 will be connected with 1, because that function is consisting of these 4 minterms and others are zeros. And now using 8 to 1 multiplexer, take these 3 signals as selection lines, inputs as selection lines, and these signals as inputs of the multiplexer. Okay, draw the symbol of the 8 to 1 multiplexer, connect ABC as selection lines, and connect all the signals as inputs. This is simple implementation using 8 to 1 multiplexer. That is, taking 8 to 1 multiplexer symbol and connecting ABC as selection lines, and the function values 0s and 1s, logic 0s and 1s are connected as inputs. What are the minterms? That is 1, 2, 5 and 7. That is 1, 2, 5 and 7 are connected with logic 1s, and remaining are connected with logic 0s. Simply connecting the F values to the inputs and ABC are as selection lines is the MUX implementation for this particular Boolean function. Okay, this is simple. Whenever if it is implemented with 2 power n by 1 size for n variables, simply use those n variables as selection lines and output connections as input of the multiplexer. Let's see one more example, that is implementation of full adder using 8 to 1 multiplexer. Full adder using 8 to 1 multiplexer. Full adder is nothing but it is using of 3 inputs. So 3 inputs, 2 power 3 is 8, using 2 power 3 by 1 multiplexer is nothing but implementation of full adder using 2 power n by 1 multiplexer. Full adder is having of 2 output expressions, one is sum and another one is carry. Our first step is write the truth table. In that truth table, write S value and carry value, and then for each output, because here multiplexer is having only one output, so for each function one multiplexer is compulsory. So therefore, to implement full adder, here 2 8 by 1 multiplexers are required. One is with sum output, another one is with carry output. Okay, so first write multiplexer, first write the truth table of the full adder, that is with inputs of A, B, C and outputs of sum and carry out. Since 3 inputs, 8 combinations, and sum value and C out value, we know this, that is sum is having of sigma min terms of 1, 2, 4 and 7, and carry is having the 3, 5, 6 and 7 min terms. How can we represent the multiplexer implementation? For this, 1 8 by 1 multiplexer, and for the second one, another 8 by 1 multiplexer. Take 2 8 by 1 multiplexers. And for these 2 multiplexes, these are the selection lines, and outputs of the first multiplexer is yes, and output of the second multiplexer is C out. And for the first multiplexer, inputs need to be connected at these values, and for the second multiplexer, inputs need to be connected as these values. Okay, now let's see the diagram implementation. That is 2 multiplexes, multiplexer 1 and multiplexer 2, for 2 functions, that is for sum and for carry out. These 2 are connected with selection signals as ABC. So these are selection signals. Same selection signals are connected for these 2. These are ABC input values. Then inputs are connected of these two table values. That is, for the sum expression 0110100. So 0110100, and for the carry out 0010111. That is 0010011. So these values are connected as input of the box 2, and these values are connected as input of the box 1. So like this, we can implement. This is simply now the combination of these two multiplexers with these inputs with selection lines of ABC will give our exact full adder truth table. So full adder can be implemented with 2 8 by 1 multiplexers like this. Okay, so this is design of a boolean function using 2n by 1 multiplexers. This is the first design part, that is a function using 2n by 1. Okay, I hope you understood this. Next we will continue the designing of boolean function using 2n-1 by 1 multiplexer. So any function can be implemented using 2n-1 by 1 max with n variables. Okay, if we are using this type of implementation, then 2n-1 multiplexes and NOT gates are used. Okay, so for this processor is, it is somewhat lengthy than the previous processor, and it is also easy only. So in this processor, first convert the given expression into SOP form if it is not there in SOP form, and next one is select one variable as input and n-1 variables as selection lines. That means, so if that function is having of n variables, then out of these n, one should be input and n-1 should be selection lines. Okay, so that means 1 plus n-1, again it is going to become as n variables. Then if you select one input signal from those n variables and remaining signals as selection lines. Okay, next, draw an implementation table. This is extra table which we have not seen in the previous implementation. Implementation table is important. Once if implementation table is defined, then logic diagram representation only. This implementation table defines what are the inputs going to be connected for the multiplexer from the given midterms. The inputs actually need to be connected at the multiplexer. Inputs will be defined from this implementation table. We will see that implementation table. Then, so after having the implementation table, finally draw multiplexer circuit by connecting the outputs of implementation table as the inputs of the multiplexer. Okay, so multiplexer inputs will be defined from the implementation table. So connect those as inputs of the multiplexer and use n-1 symbols as selection lines and 1 as input line. Okay, so this is the processor. We can understand this processor with the help of an example. Let's see the example part. In this same example which we have seen just now, that is full adder using 8x1 multiplexers we have seen. Now same the full adder using 4x1 multiplexers, because full adder using the input variables as 3 ABC. So if it is using the 2n by 1 means 2^3 8x1 multiplexer, but we are using here as 2n-1 by 1 multiplexer, that is nothing but 4x1 multiplexer. Okay, so we are seeing the full adder implementation using 2n-1 by 1 multiplexers. In that, what is the first step? Get the SOP form of expressions. For the full adder, what are the expressions? Sum and carry out are the expressions. So first write these two expressions, sum and carry out. Sum expression is sigma m of 1 2 4 7, and for the carry out 3 5 6 7 are the expressions. That is the first step. And the second step, what is the second step? Second step is select one signal as input and remaining two signals as selection signals. So for this full adder, we define sum and carry out as outputs. And if it is taking of three inputs A, B, C, okay, we can take A as an input and B, C as the selection signals, or A, B as the selection signals and C as the input, or A and C as the selection signals and B as the input. Out of these three signals, any signal can be taken as a selection line or input. Okay, for the example sake, here I am taking as A signal as input and B, C are as selection lines. Okay, so second step is over. Then the third step. Third step is what? Implementation table drawing. Okay, for the implementation table drawing, before drawing the implementation table exactly, we need to write one truth table. That truth table with ABC values like this. ABC values, that is 0, 0, 0, since three variables are there, it is having 8 combinations. Okay, total of 8 combinations. Now, functions. Functions are what? Sum and carry out. Two output functions are there. So, simply I am writing here as output function. Write output function as in terms of whatever the input we are taking A. In terms of A or A bar for the respective all these minterms. Here, A is 0. So, for this write as A bar and here also A is 0. So, A bar and here A bar and here also A is 0. So, if A is 0, write A bar. And for all the next four combinations, its value is A only. So, output function is representing in terms of either A bar or A at the input side. So, just having the minterms, the first minterm A bar, second minterm A bar, third minterm also A bar. These are the minterms of M0, M1, M2, M3, like that it is M7. Okay. So, writing all the minterms as the A bar or A is the first step before writing the implementation table. Now start the implementation table. This implementation table using two rows of all these minterms combination. Okay, it is writing like this. It is using the two rows of all these minterms, and these two rows, the first row defines the A bar row. And second row minterms are representing the A row. So, these A and A bar are we are going to, A is selected as input of the multiplexer. Therefore, choose A 0 terms and A 1 terms in the truth table. So, in this table, A 0 minterms are what? M0, M1, M2, M3. So, simply represent 0 term, 1 term, 2 and 3 minterms. 0, 1, 2, 3. Since in the Boolean expressions are in SOPs, we have written only 1, 2, 3, 4. So, like that, just represent like that. Then, A terms are nothing but from 4 to 7. So, write 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Take the variable which is going to be applied as input to the multiplexer and write minterms in two rows. In the first row, the minterms which are having A bar. And the second row minterms which are consisting of A as the variables. Then write here actual inputs of the multiplexer. So since here we are using 4 by 1 multiplexer, therefore write 4 inputs. Actual inputs which we are going to connect at the multiplexer are I0 to I3 with different signals. Okay, write inputs of the multiplexer. These are inputs of ones. We need to find here with implementation table what are the values, actual values to the I0 connected, I1 connected, I2 and I3 need to be connected in terms of A, A bar or logic 0, logic 1. Okay. So, in the construction of implementation table, this is the first step. That is, have this kind of table, get the A bar and A terms, and write those terms in two rows. And for these two rows across it, write actual inputs of the multiplexer I0 to I3. Okay. Now take the original output functions for the sum and carry. Okay. For sum, one implementation table. For carry, another implementation table is going to be taken so that inputs are going to be find out for the multiplexers. So for sum. Now for the sum implementation table. Same implementation table with A bar, A and I0, I1, I2 and I3. Mintons are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Same table just I have repeated here. Now, take this sum expression and whatever the mintons are given, just circle those mintons in this implementation table. So, 1 is the minterm, circle it, and 2 is there, circle it, and then 4 is there, circle, and 7 is there, just circle. Okay, so circle the given minterms. Now, the input definition is going to be start, input finding for the multiplexer. Here, if the two minterms are circled, then assign 1 as the signal here, or if only one minterm is circled, then take that respective variable as the output, or if nothing is circled, then take 0 as the output. So here this term is circled, so take as A, and here this A bar term is circled, so take A bar as the signal, and A bar is circled in the second minterm also, so A bar is the output, and here second term is circled, take as A. So whatever the variable, if single variable is circled, then take that respective variable as the output, and if two are circled, then take 1, and if nothing is circled, then take 0 as the output. Okay, so these are going to be actual inputs of MUX. That is, for the MUX I0, A will be collected, for the MUX I1, A bar will be collected, I2, A bar will be collected, I3, they will be connected. Like that, we are going to connect these signals for the sum multiplexer. Similarly, for carry multiplexer also, the same processor. For the carry multiplexer also, same processor. That is, take the implementation table. What are the carry expression? Carry expression is, carry is equal to sigma m of 3, 5, 6, 7. So, first those terms circuit. So, 3 is circuit, 5, 6 and 7. All those are circuit. Then what is the output definition? That is, here in this column, 2 rows are not circuit, assign 0. And here, the A term is circuit, so A. And in this column also A is circled, A. In this column 2 are circled, so let us give 1. So these are the inputs of multiplexer which is used for the carry implementation. Now two multiplexers with inputs defined and selection lines are also defined. So finally, drawing the logic diagram by applying the inputs as output of the implementation table. Okay, so this is multiplexer 1 and this is multiplexer 2. It outputs one as sum and another one as carry. And selection lines, out of 3 variables we have taken B and C as the selection lines. And for the inputs, 4 inputs for the sum and carry, we need to collect now the signals from the implementation tables. Here for the carry implementation table, signals are 0, A, A and 1. And for the sum, what we got? For the sum, just now, A bar and A, we got for the sum. So apply those two, A bar, and A. So this is finally full adder implementation using 4 by 1 multiplex. This total is acting as full adder. A taking the BC selection lines, applying these as the inputs. Outputs are sum and carry. Like this, we can implement full adder using 2 4 by 1 multiplexers also. Okay. Let's see once again. First, writing the truth table of the full adder, having the sum and carry expressions. Okay. In terms of this was the sum expression and carry expression. Then next, getting the implementing the implementation tables. That is, this is the implementation table for sum, and this is the implementation table for carry. Okay. So implementation table in net circling for the given min terms in the sum 1 2 4 7 are circled. So whatever the min term is circled, that respective variable is taken as output of the implementation table. That will be connected as input of the original mass. Then for carry, 3 terms are given as 3 5 6 and 7. Now because of two min terms are circled, one is output. Here these two one is circled, so A is output. Here nothing is circled, 0 is the output. So these are outputs of the implementation table, which are going to be applied as inputs of the multiplexer. Okay, so A is the input and B and C are taken as selection lines here. So connecting B and C, this is B and C, and here B and C are connected as selection signals for that multiplexer. So this is 4 by 1 mux and this is also 4 by 1 mux. Outputs are one is sum, another one is carry out. Okay, this is the implementation of full adder using 4 by 1 multiplexers. Like this, any function can be implemented using 2 power n minus 1 by 1 multiplexers. I hope you understood. Like this, you can solve for any Boolean function implementation. Let's see another example, which is implementing with the help of multiplexer. So here the expression is f of abc is equal to sigma m of the min terms 1 2 3 0.6 with don't care 7. It means the expression given is f of abc is equal to sigma m of 1 2 3 5 6 plus don't care of 7. This is the given expression. So in the previous example, we have seen full adder implementation using 4 by 1 multiplexer, and now we will see some example with don't care condition also, which includes don't care condition also. So here the variables are 3 variables A, B, C. If it is implementing with 2 power n minus 1 by 1, then it requires 4 by 1 multiplexer. So we are going to see this implementation with 4 by 1 multiplexer. In that, what are the steps? First, we need an expression in the form of SOP. Then we need to select one signal as input and two signals are as selection lines. So here, out of ABC signals, we can take one signal as input, the remaining two signals are as selection signals. ABC 3 variables. Out of these 3 variables, we can choose one signal as input and other two signals are as selection lines. So here, 3 cases can be possible. That means one time A can be taken as input, other two are the selection signals, or B can be taken as input, other two may be selection signals, or C may be taken as input and other B's, A and B signals as the selection signals. Okay. So in the previous example of the full adder implementation, we have taken A MSB as input signal, BCR as a selection signals. Now let us see this example with 3 cases of taking the input signals and selection lines. That is, first case, taking the MSB signal as input signal and remaining 2 signals are as selection signals. Take the first case of this. So for this, what we need to do? First, we need to write a table like this. That table is going to define the min terms which are going to give the selecting input signal A as 0th place and 1th place. That is, taking the ABC 3 variables, and so since ABC 3 variables, we are going to have 8 combinations, and for these 8 combinations, write A bar and A as per the A value. That is, here first four zeros, but we write A bar as the A, and then next four combinations A is 1, so therefore write as A. If it is 1, write A, and if it is 0, write A bar. Now the minterms are minterms. Minterms corresponding to A bar variables and A variables are minterms 0, 3 zeros means minterm 0, 0, 0, 1 means minterm 1. So minterm 0, 1, 2, 3. For these 4 minterms, A value is A bar. And for the other 4 minterms, that is 4, 5, 6 and 7, for these minterms A value is 1. So in the implementation table writing, write the minterms of 0, 1, 2, 3 in the A bar row and write 4 to 7 in the 8th row. So therefore, A bar row is this implementation table. So start the implementation table. In the implementation table, in the A bar row, minterms 0, 1, 2, 3. So write 0, 1, 2, 3 as the minterms. And in the 8th row, 4, 5, 6, 7 as the minterms. Okay? Then, as per the given minterms from the SOP form, just circle the given minterms. What are the minterms given? Sigma m of 1, 1 is given, so circle it. 2 is given in our problem. 5 is given, so 3 is given, just circle it. And 5 and 6 with don't care of 7. Okay? With don't care of 7. Don't care means what? Don't care means it may be a value of 0 or 1. So we can consider that value for the both cases. So as of now, circle it, don't care also. Now what are the values? From the implementation table, output of the implementation table can be written as, since two row values are not circled, so output is 0. And here 2 are circled, 1. 2 minterms are circled, 1. And 2 minterms are circle if it is considering as 1, and if it is considering as 0, it is not circle. So if this don't care is considering as 1, then these two are circled means output is 1. Or if this don't care is taking as 0, if it is not circled means output is A bar. Okay, so for this I3 line, 1 or A bar is going to be collected depending upon the don't care value, and remaining 3 inputs are 0, 1, 1. So, these are the acting as input of the multiplexer, that is output of the implementation table. So, what is the next step? Drawing the logic diagram of multiplexer or logic symbol of the multiplexer with connecting of these values as input to the multiplexer. So, I0 is connected with 0, I1 is connected with 1, I2 is connected with 1, and I3 is connected with 1 or A bar. So, 0, 1, 1, 1 or A bar. These are the all inputs of the multiplexer connected, taken from the output of the implementation table and taking the B and C as the selection signal. Okay? Then output is equal to output function of ABC. ABC, and it is the value of minterms. This is the function. So, like this, by selecting the MSB bit A as the input and BC as the selection lines, we can find the first minterms in the A bar row and A row in the implementation table, and from that finding the output of the implementation table, and then connect that output of the implementation table to input of the multiplexer, and connecting the remaining two signals as selection lines of the multiplexer gives the output F implementation with 4x1 multiplexer. Okay, this is the first case. Let's see the second case. Second case, for the same example, taking the AB as selection signals. Okay, means, so our variables are three variables. Function is having the three variables, A, B, C. C is the LSB bit and AB are the remaining most significant bits. Now taking the C as the input and AB are as the selection signals. Okay, now this is the case. So for this, what is the first step? So in this, first decide the column values of the or row values of the implementation table for the inputs in terms of C value. For that, write a table like this with ABC values Okay, and since ABC are three variables, eight columns will be written. Eight different minterms. Minterm 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 7. Then write F function in terms of C. C, when it is 0, C bar. When it is 1, C. So for the first, C is 0. Therefore write C bar. Then 1, C, 0, C bar. 1, C, 0, C bar. 1, C, 0, C bar. And 1, C. So wherever C is present as 1, write C. And 0 is present, write as C bar. Now, what are the minterm values for this? This C bar term minterm is 0. Then the next minterm is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So, what are the C bar minterms? C bar is having the minterms of first 0, the next 2 and then next is 4 and the next is 6. So, minterms, C bar is consisting of 0, 2, 4 and 6. Similarly, what are the C minterms? C minterms are 1 and 3 and 5, 7. So, minterms of 1, 3, 5, 7 are the C minterms. Now, use these two minterms as row elements in the implementation table. So, let's see the implementation table. Implementation table. In the implementation table, now the input signal is C. So write C bar and C. Then inputs of the multiplexer are I0, I1, I2 and I3. And we need to define what are the values of I0 to I3 are going to be connected in terms of C, because we have taken C as the input. So now write all these minterms. First 0 to 4, 6 C bar term, 0 to 4, 6. And then 1, 3, 5, 7. Then second minterm is given. So 1 is given. Then 2 is given. 3 is given. Then 5. And the next minterm is 6. And 7 is don't care. So that will be considered as 1 or 0. And now if 1 is, then circle. If it is considered as 0, then no circle. First case, using the 1. Okay. Then since this one minterm is circled respective to C, output is C. Then two are circled, output is 1. And C minterm is circled, so output is C. Both are circled, 1. Or if this dot care is taken as 0, then what will happen? Only C bar term is circled, so C bar. Okay. I0 is equal to C, I1 is equal to 1, I2 is equal to C and I3 is equal to 1 or C bar. Connect these as input of the multiplexer. So this is the multiplexer of 4 by 1 and now input is equal to in terms of C and selection signals are AB. So writing the selection signals are AB and applying the input signal from the implementation table. That is C, 1 and C. Next, with the don't care condition, as 1 or 0 we got 1 and C bar. So 1 and C bar is connected. Then it is implementing the function of f. F of ABC is equal to the given function. Okay. This is same as the previous case. That is, output is the same, but applying the input and selection signals are different. This is the second case. Now let's see the third case. Third case, that is taking the AC as the selection signals and B as the input signal. So our variables are A, B, C. Now taking the B as input signal and A and C both are as selection signals. We are doing this case. Okay. So for this again, write a table like this and write the function in terms of B or B bar. Whenever it is 0, write B bar and whenever it is 1, write B. So take the B, that is values are having 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. So 0, 0 means we are going to write B bar, 1, 1 means BB, then again 0, 0, B bar, 1, 1 is BB. Okay. Now the respective minterms for B bar, respective minterms for B bar are the first minterm 0 and the next minterm 1 and for B bar, next minterm is, this is 1, double 0 is 4 and the next minterm is 5. So 0, 1, 4, 5 are the minterms respective to the minterm of variable of B bar. Okay, so in the implementation table, in this we are taking the B as the input. So therefore B bar and B we are going to write as the first column. And B bar minterms are 0, 1, 4, 5. So write 0, 1, 4 and 5. Next remaining minterms are for B. These are 0, 1, 0 means it is equal to 2. And 0, 1 means it is equal to 3. And then it is equal to 6 and 7. So 2, 3, 6, 7 are the minterms for the B. Write those minterms. Now depending upon the given expression, circuit. So 1 is given circulate, then 2 circle, 3 circle, 5, okay, 6 and 7 based on the board care value 1. Okay, then as per the circle we decide the output. Since it is circled, B is output, and for I1 both are circled 1, and for I2 B respective term is circled B, and for I3 both are circled if don't care is 1, so 1, or if it is not circled, if it is taken as 0, then B bar is circled, so the input is B bar. Okay, then inputs or outputs of the implementation table are inputs of the multiplexer are I0 is equal to B, I1 is equal to 1, I2 is equal to B, and I3 is equal to 1 or B bar. Okay, so the same connected B1, B1 or B bar as inputs, and selection lines as A and C. So connect the selection signals as A and C. Therefore, it can be implemented the output expression of F. Okay, let us see our given question. Like this, the same expression can be implemented with the 4 by 1 multiplexer only by changing the input and selection lines as per our requirement. Okay, any signal can be used as input, any signal can be used as selection line. Like this, we can implement any boolean function with any number of variables with 2 power n minus 1 by 1 multiplexer. Okay, I hope you understood this. So we have seen two examples. One is ladder implementation with 4 by 1 multiplexer, and next with don't cares one expression with 4 by 1 multiplexer using the three different cases of changing the selection lines and input. Okay. Next. So these two examples are with three variables only. Next let's see one more example, that is with 4 variable. That is with 4 variable. Let us see this example. So 4 variables A, B, C, D are the inputs. Sigma M of on the minterms given 4 variables. Okay, what is the first step? SOP is given. And what is the second step? We are implementing this with what? Since it is using the 4 variables, we are going to implement this with 2 power n minus 1 by 1 max. That is simply 2 power 4 minus 1, that is 3. So 8 by 1 max we are going to use for this implementation. 8 by 1 max. For the implementation of 8 by 1 max, the first step is implementation table. So write the implementation table for this implementation table. For this implementation table, since 8 inputs are there, so writing as I0, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6, I7. 8 inputs. Then which signal we are taking as the input? Either A or B or B or C. Okay? So one simplicity case, I am taking A as the input. So A bar and A are the two rows. A bar terms, since A is the MSB, first it will have total of 4 zeros and then 4 ones. Okay? So 4 zeros and 4 ones. 4 zeros and 4. Sorry. Since it is of n is equal to 4, since it is of n is equal to 4, this truth table is consisting of total of 16 combinations, that is from 4 zeros to 4 ones. So in this first 8 combinations are zeros and then 8 combinations are ones. Okay, 8 combinations and 8 combinations. Therefore, first eight combinations are nothing but 0 to 7 and next eight combinations are 8 to 15. So, if I have taken A as the input signal, I can directly write the min terms here. That is, A bar min terms are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and then 1 min terms are 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. From this, find the actual values of the output of the implementation table by circling the given min terms. 1 is given, so circle it. Then 3 is given, circle it. Then 4, next 11 is given, and 12 is given. Then 13 is given, 14 and 15. These are the given min terms. Okay, then write the values. No min term is selected, therefore 0. Here A bar is circle, so A bar. Again, no min term is circled, 0. Then 2 are circled, 1. 2 are circled, 1. And A term is circled. So, therefore, A is the output for I5 to I7. So, what is this actually? This is output of implementation table. Or, it will be acting as, we are connecting this as input to the multiplexer. Okay, we are connecting this as the input to the multiplexer. Okay, so let's see its implementation table once again. Now we are writing, taking the values from the min terms of A2, that means 0 to 15, all 16 combinations, by selecting A as input and BCD as selection signals. A min term is first 8 combinations 0, that means 0 to 7 we have written A bar row, and A row A to 15 written. And then from the given min terms equation, just a circle, and as per the circle, we have written the output of the implementation table. Then these are connecting as input of the multiplexer. Okay? So, it's a, I hope you understood the implementation table of this four variable multiplexer. The same I have shown here as a, once again, that is 0, A bar, 0, 1, 1 and A. Okay. Then from this, these are using as input of the mux. Input of the 8 by 1 mux. Now just to draw the input of the, with these inputs 8 by 1 multiplexer, if we draw that, this is the logic diagram. Okay. Logic diagram of mux. So, inputs are applying 0 as the first line. This is 0, then A bar, and then next again 0, then 1, 1. Next 3 signals are applied as A, and selection signals are B, C, D. So, selection signals are applied as B, C, D. Okay, output is equal to our function F. Output is equal to function F. This is the implementation of a given expression with the four variables with 8 by 1 multiplexer. Okay, I hope you understood this example also. So, like this, you can design any example with the multiplexer. Okay, next. Take these as assignment questions. Solve all these questions as the assignment so that you can get better understanding. And in the four questions, min terms form is given. And the fifth question, just name is given, that is full subtractor. So, from this you get two expressions. Okay. Full subtractor is having the two outputs, that is one is difference and borrow, and write that SOP form and solve it. Then, summary of today's lecture is, what we have seen? First, we have started mux applications and need of the multiplexer. And then, multiplexer designs, designs of 2 by 1. And 4 by 1 and 8 by 1 and etc. We have seen design in terms of logic gates. And then we have seen multiplexer implementation with the multiplexer only, that is called the multiplexer tree implementation. And then implementation of Boolean functions with these multiplexers with the help of 2 power n by 1 multiplexers for n variable function, or 2 power n minus 1 by 1 multiplexers for n variable Boolean functions. We have seen all these in today's lecture. I hope you understood. So, read well, read the textbooks and solve the exercise problems. If you have any doubt, then ask me. Thank you.